Good morning. Today we will report about the prophets. So this is Isaiah. He was a prophet who lived in the 8th century BC, Kingdom of Judah. Jews and the Christians considered the book of Isaiah part of their biblical canon. He is the first listed volume at the earliest of the Nevi'im Achronim, the Latin prophets. The first verse of the book of Isaiah states that the prophet prophesied during the reign of Uzziah or Azariah, Jotham, Ahaz, and Ezekiah, the kings of Judah. Uzziah's reign was 52 years in the middle of the 8th century BC, and Isaiah himself began his ministry a few years before Uzziah's death, probably in the 740s BC. Isaiah lived until the 14th year of Ezekiah's reign, who died 698 BC, and may have been contemporary for some years in the Manasseh. Thus, Isaiah must have prophesied for as long as 64 years. Isaiah's wife was called the prophetess, either because she was endowed with a prophetic gift like Deborah and Huldah, or simply because she was the wife of the prophet. The second interpretation that it was simply an honorary titles like they have two sons, naming one Shirjasud, meaning a remnant shall return, and the younger Merar Shalabaza, meaning spoilability plunders speedily. Yes. So the next prophet is Jeremiah. The great prophet Jeremiah lived during the most crucial period of Judah's existence as a kingdom. He saw the destruction of Jerusalem and the Holy Temple after he had incessantly warned his people to mend their ways before it was too late. And when the catastrophe finally overwhelmed his people, he was the one who bitterly lamented Israel's terrible fate in the book of Eklat, Lamentations, which we read on the Tisha B'Av. The anniversary of the catastrophe. At some time, he proved to be a true friend by helping his stricken people to bear the blow with courage and dignity, and by pointing out to them the path that would lead to the restoration of redemption. Jeremiah was born of a priestly family in the town of Anatol in Benjamin. His father was the prophet and high priest Tekiah. He began his prophecy during the time of the prophet Zephaniah and the prophetess Huldah in the 13th year of King Josiah's reign. The destruction of the northern kingdom by the Assyrians was still fresh in the memory of the people of Judah, and you can imagine in what state of spiritual agitation they were living at that time. Under these conditions, Jeremiah began his prophecy. One of his first missions was to go to the exiled 10 tribes of Israel to bring them courage and hope, and to induce many of them to return to their native land. Jeremiah witnessed the fall of the Assyrian Empire and the death of King Josiah. Though the people did mourn the death of their beloved King Josiah, the chief mourner was the prophet Jeremiah, for he knew very well that with the untimely passing of his past pious king, the end of Jubilee as an independent state was unavoidable. Indeed, after Josiah's death, the people soon reverted to idolatry. Jeremiah was struck by the new relapse of his people and strove hard to steal the type of spiritual depravity which was threatening to unturning their high moral standards. The next is Ezekiel 4, Julio Archer.